Look at that flesh. Pink and plump. Oh, girl. Tender and fresh. Not one lump. Hello, little girl. This one's especially large. Delicious. Hello, little girl. What's your rush? You're missing all the flowers. The sun won't set for hours. Take your time.
You said straight ahead, not to delay or be misled.
But slow, little girl. And hush. The birds are singing sweetly. You'll miss the birds completely. You're traveling so fleetly. Grandmother first, then Miss Plump. What a delectable couple. Oh, to perfection, one brittle, one supple, one moment, my dear.
Said, come what may, follow the path and never stray.
Just so, little girl, any path, so many worth exploring. Just one would be so boring. And of course you're ignoring. Think of those crisp, aging bones. It's something fresh on the palate. Think of that scrumptious carnality twice in one day. There's no possible way to describe how you feel when you're talking to your me.
Mother said not to stray. Still, I suppose a small delay. Granny might like a fresh bouquet. Goodbye, Mr. Wolf. He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I run from him. He spread pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares. And I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? You think, make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, it's a thought. What would be his response? But then what if he knew who you were when you know that you're not what he thinks that he wants? And then what if you are what a prince would envision? Although how can you know who you are till you know what you want, what you don't? So then which do you pick? Where you're safe, out of sight, and yourself, but where everything's wrong. Or where everything's right, and you know that you'll never belong. And whichever you pick, do it quick, cause you're starting to stick to the steps of the palace. It's your first big decision. The choice isn't easy to make. To arrive at a ball is exciting and all. It's you there, though it's scary. And it's fun to deceive when you know you can leave, but you have to be wary. There's a lot that's at stake, but you've stalled long enough, cause you're still standing stuck in the stuff on the steps. Better run along home and avoid the collision. Even though they don't care, you'll be better off there, where there's nothing to choose, so there's nothing to lose. So you pry up your shoes, and from out of the blue, and without any guide, you know what your decision is, which is not to decide. You'll just leave him a clue. For example, a shoe, and then see what he'll do. Now it's he and not you who is stuck with a shoe in a stew, in the goo. And you've learned something too, something you never knew, on the steps of the palace.
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while leaving her on.
You've changed. You're daring. You're different in the woods. More sure, more sharing. You're getting us through the woods. If you could see, you're not the man who started, and much more open-hearted. You're passionate, charming, considerate, clever.
It's true. I thought one was enough. It's not true. Takes two of us, you came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It took two of us, it takes care. It takes patience and fear and despair to change. Though you swear to change, who can tell if you do?
Giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. When you're way up high and you look below at the world you've left and the things you know, little more than a glance, enough to show you just how small you are. When you're way up high and you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known, where the sky is lead and the earth is stone, you're free to do whatever pleases you, exploring things you never dare, cause you just don't care. When suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. Big, tall, terrible lady giant sweeping the floor. And she gives you food and she gives you rest, and she draws you close to her giant breast, and you know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky. Only just when you've made a friend and all, you know she's big but you don't feel small. Someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead, your stomach's stone, and you're really scared being all alone. And it's then that you long for the things you've known and the world you've left and the little you own. The fun is done, you steal what you can and run. And you scramble down, you look below as the world you know begins to grow. The house is your mother at the door. The roof, the house, and the world you never thought to explore. In the sky. There are